Today, we're going to have a lesson that's going to have three clear steps to it. The first step, we're going to do a number talk, very much like the number talks we've been looking at the last couple of days, building on our knowledge of the buttons task. But first, I want to start off with just like an in and out table. Remember we did the number cruncher last week at the end of the week with Ms. Trainer? And today, we're going to start off, I've got a rule, it's a tricky rule I'm going to work on. So we're going to do a number talk. Move from that number talk, we're going to do some analyzing of work. Remember you guys took the buttons task. I went through and looked at how you guys were thinking about the task, and I've chosen a couple of things for us to talk about today. So we're going to talk about those things and then look at different ways to represent how we see those patterns growing. So we're going to start with a number talk. Guess my rule. I got to give you some parameters though. I appreciate the hands. Well, there's a reason now. If I give you free rein, you might have a point that's not going to show up on our graph over here. And what I'm going to have you guys do as you guess point is come up and place the coordinate point on our graph. So if you guess an input or an output, I'm going to ask you or challenge you to come up and graph it. So the parameters. Your number, whatever your number is, the x that you guess, is going to have to be greater than or equal to 0. But I want it to be, I also want it to be less than or equal to 10. Christina?
10.
All right. Would you like to come and plot that?
Que pasa?
You can pass. You want to pass? Can someone come and plot this point on our graph right here? This one graph where you think it goes. Maybe somebody else can think of another point for us, another x value. You know what, before we go on to that, David, can you just explain to us what you how you placed your dot there?
So I went 10 to 10 on the x, and then I went 27. Right here.
Very good. Thank you. Another x value. Guess my rule. Kelsey.
6.
Can I see thumbs up? Who thinks they know what the rule is at this point? All right, let's guess another number then. Let's guess another number. This time I want you to continue guessing an x. I don't think we're ready to guess a y value yet. Give me an x. Megan. Okay. 20. Now I'm not gonna let 20 happen because I gave you parameters earlier. So Megan, can you give me a different number that's in between 0 and 10?
8.
Good guess. Y value. Who thinks they have a Y value that will work with my rule? Zach.
12.
Okay, 12. Let me see.
Bottom's 3 is 15, minus 3.
Someone come and plot this point. Griffin, do you have a question or a comment?
I was going to say an output.
An output number?
Yeah.
All right. So am I to understand that you think you know what the rule is then?
Spotlight.
All right. How many, can I see the show of thumbs? How many people feel they know? Just tight to your chest so I can see what's going on. Thumbs up, thumbs down if you don't know it. Thumbs in the middle if you're almost there, not sure. All right, let's do one more point then. Griffin's going to give us a y value. And remember, that x value is going to be in between 0 and 10. Pardon me, greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 10.
0.
Oh, so x is 0.
No, y. That's cheap.
Y is 0.
Wow, I'm surprised that actually I didn't guess that.
hear something whispering. Is zero a possibility for this? Can you guys turn to your partner?
I think it's